this year at job satisfaction. People are not getting a job satisfaction. People are not getting the things that they want, the way they deserve, and the solution will be bad. Strikes and lockout. Always there is a strike. For every now and then there is a strike. Every now and then there is a fear or threat by the management to lug it out, and the solution is bad. Or absenteeism is heavy. Around 20% absenteeism is every day. What it indicates? Why people don't like to come. They are not getting the way want. They are against the wage structure. They are against the wage policy. They are against entire companies working, the culture. IR is going to be bad. Wage structure is not proper. What they want, they are not getting. It is always below the minimum level. And the solution will be bad. There is no any kind of workers' participation in management. WPM we call it as. I never give a chance to people to come and say something. I dictate my term. And the solution will be bad or not? Grievance handling is poor. Whenever anybody makes a complaint, I neglect it. Illiteracy. Political leadership. These are all the causes, determinants by which you can understand IR is good or bad. Now, when you see this particular figure, diagram, what you get to know? If I ask you, by way of this diagram, what the scope you are getting? Why should I learn IR? What you are going to get out of it? The figure which is in front of you, what this figure makes you to, is trying to tell you? Suppose if I ask you, why should we study industrial relation? I am telling you something about actors and factors and various things that are. When you look at this particular diagram, what exactly makes you to understand? The scope of IR. It gives me the scope to understand how the healthy management union relation is and what basis. It makes me to understand. It makes me to understand how these actors and the factors are interrelated. They will have to understand each other. I get a scope to understand. I get a scope to understand how the unions are being made. Which are the laws are there by which union can be registered or recognized. We understand basic human rights. Rights of the people to be united. I get a scope to understand. I get a scope to understand why there are number of disputes are taking place. I get a scope to understand why reasons of dispute, and I get a scope to understand what are the machineries we have by which dispute can be solved out. Maybe you have negotiation, maybe you have the mediation, you maybe have arbitrations under Industrial Dispute Act, section 3 to 7B. You got a number of machineries, I get a scope to understand. You get a scope to understand what is the importance of industrial democracy at work. You get to know the scope of collective bargaining, the way, the process of discussion in a very democratic way. You get a scope to understand. You get a scope to understand the employers' associations. You get a scope to understand unions being recognized under various acts. Why there is the requirement of the union is. You get a scope to understand how important entire organized culture, the policies, strategies, mission is, which reflect into bad industrialization or good industrialization. I get a scope to understand all these things. Clear? And why sometime the industrialization goes bad, causes of poor IR, why industrialization goes bad? Sometime, there's always a strike and lockout takes place. People are not working, the grievances are there. Normally, the relation between employer and employee goes wrong. On what ground? Ground number one, both the parties are not able to safeguard their own economic interests. Second, the mental inertia, attitude of management and union towards each other. The way you are employed, you always look at me. in a negative way. You are giving less and less output and trying to get a maximum return. What will be my attitude? Get a maximum return in terms of output by paying less and less and less. My industrialization will go wrong or not? Unduly heavy workload. He's working, making me to work like a donkey every day. There is no any proper working conditions. There is no proper welfare. The workload is too much. The way I'm working, no overtime being given. Wage structure is poor. Salary is not at minimum level. We have at least a fair level salary. Should be above the minimum. No. Last 10 years, we are at the minimum level salary. Who will work? Nobody gets a job satisfaction. There is always inter fight between the management, intra-union fight between the union. There is no proper cooperation between the management and union. There is no proper personnel policies. Inadequate introduction to the automation. The way management makes the change without a notice. Inadequate facilities. There is always a prestige fight. You are fighting with me, the pride, prestige. I am having the prestige fight, industrialization goes bad. So the way, industrialization, we have studied, what is industrialization, what are the objectives, what are the determinants, what are the scope, and what are the causes of poor IR. Any doubt with this? Now we see what is grievance. Grievance is a complaint. There can be complaint on the part of employee. Reason of making a complaint, a grievance can be anything. Either the working conditions are not being good, salary is not good, there is a problem in the machinery, having a techno problem, maybe having economic problem, or maybe related to infrastructure, related to boss subordinate relationship, maybe way of any kind of working operation process areas, maybe related to any kind of working environment, the culture, the disputes, number of problems are there where the person is not getting a chance to solve this. This is called a person who is making a complaint. It's called an aggrieved employee. He is an aggrieved employee who makes the complaint. Suppose there is a complaint, as I go talk to you, complaint can be because of anything which I want to solve the complaint. So that grievance handling, the grievance has to be handled properly. If you are not able to handle that grievance in a proper way, the grievances will be more, complaint will be more, and the industrialization will go bad. There can be a loss of your profit, can be a loss of your production, loss of your quality, loss of quantity, indiscipline, entire culture will go bad. That is why it is necessary that whenever any person makes a complaint which is related to organizational setup problem, it is to be solved in a systematic way. To make people happy, to motivate them at work, and plus above all, to keep a good industrialization, there must be certain kind of grievance handling procedure. There must be a grievance handling procedure. This particular aspect being thought of it by ILO convention in 1955, where there were the members of management, union and the government. In that convention, in 1955 labor convention, it was decided to design a proper grievance handling procedure which will be applicable in the company. It's not by the law, but it was a common understanding that people should adopt this kind of handling procedure and should implement that at a organizational level. The way it was discussed, and in that meeting, proper model grievance handling procedure was being drafted out. They are drafted. In that, understanding what was a procedure being drafted that I will tell you. Suppose this is an aggrieved employee. Whenever he has any complaint, the complaint has to be solved. Under grievance handling procedure, he can go first to, that procedure is, he can go first to grievance handling officer. Grievance handling officer is appointed by the management to look after the complaint of this aggrieved employee. Whenever this complaint goes to grievance handling officer, the grievance handling officer will have to solve that complaint and give the solution, communicate the solution to the aggrieved employee within 48 hours. And whatever the solution being given, that will be communicated to this particular employee. My friend, this is what the solution is. If it's agreed, grievance is sorted out. But it's not necessary that he will accept it. I ask him, oh, what is the solution given by the grievance handling officer? Are you happy with this? No. Got angry. He's not happy. Then, in that case, he can go to department head. When he is not happy with the solution given by grievance handling officer, he may go to department head. Department head will go through that complaint and will try to give the solution within 3 days. And that solution will be communicated to this particular aggrieved employee. My friend, the department head has given this solution. Are you happy with this? He may say, no, sir. Then in that case, he can go to grievance committee. Grievance committee consists of the members of management union, the committees. Whenever his department is not able to solve, he may suggest to go to grievance committee. The matter goes to grievance committee. Grievance committee will have to go through that complaint and they will have to recommend solution. Recommend means give. They cannot make it compulsory. Recommend the solution within 7 days. Whatever the recommendation being given, we just communicate to this aggrieved employee. Whatever the session given by the grievance committee, are you happy with this? No. In that case, the personnel officer of that company take the matter at a local level, local management. Whatever the solution, recommendation being given by the grievance committee, local management will think of it and they will give solution within 3 days. That again also will be communicated. Are you happy with the solution of this? No. He is not happy. Then he may go to higher management, top management, with his representative, along with his union representative, when the matter goes to higher management. And whenever it goes to higher management will discuss that matter and they will give the decision within a week. We are going to communicate him. Whatever the decision being given by the higher management is this. Are you happy with this? No. In that case, he may ask for arbitrations. That is, it goes outside. He may ask for legal help. Total grievance handling procedure within the company gets over here. Even though he is not happy with the decision given by, he can go to take help of labor court or any conciliation officer, means legal help he can take in-house. Grievance handling procedure gets over. Clear? What is the intention of having this kind of procedure? What what are the problems we are having within the four walls. We should solve it at home only. Instead of going that out, we should solve the problem within our family or not. Intention is that it should be sorted out within the company, by which people will be happy. If the problem is sorted out right here, suppose nobody will make a complaint. As more the complaint, more the industry solution bad. Less the complaint, industry solution is good enough. Sometimes people say, oh, what a grievance procedure is. Whenever we make a small complaint, company solves that immediately. People will not make more problems. People will not make more complaint. But you, if you are neglecting the complaint, complaint will be more. And then it goes beyond the control. And person is not getting that particular decision, solution, he is likely to go and take the help in a labor court. Is it not? But the in-house, it gets over here. That is called a grievance handling procedure. Clear? Any doubt? Now, when we discuss on this, we'll discuss about what is a discipline and how that we handle the discipline. When you word the discipline is concerned, what do you mean by there is certain code of ways you have to behave in that way? Code of ways which gives the instruction in what way your activity should be. Maybe your operational level or your behavioral level. You have to be in discipline, means you have to obey certain norms, certain rules and regulations. If you are going against, we say it is indiscipline. Is it not? Now, whenever person is making a misconduct, it may lead to anything. Suppose you are going against the company, or there is some kind of insubordinations. You are not taking the orders of the management. Insubordinations are you are abusing management, instigating others. Whatever is being given under the Model Standing Order Act, what is a discipline or what is a misbehavior? Misbehavior is what that is being given under the Act. Whenever any person, there is a bad discipline, there is a negative discipline, it indicates that there is a misconduct. When there is a misconduct, what can be done? So how to solve, how to deal with people, those who are having a misconduct? If you are making a misconduct every now and then, we cannot neglect. It should be necessary by which you can take action against the employee. That action is known as domestic inquiry. How to go for domestic inquiry, that we are going to see that. Procedure for domestic inquiry in case there is a indiscipline. We'll discuss that. Now see, suppose I write down here. Procedure for domestic inquiry. So on this employee's part, there is a misconduct. On his part, he's not obeying rules and regulation, or he's being abusing, he's below working below norms, indiscipline, habitual absenteeism, number of things are there. Whenever there is any such a kind of indiscipline, we have to see that what is the intensity of it and what action should be taken. For example, that the misconduct is not that severe, we just warn him orally not to repeat it and we leave it like that. But whenever the discipline, that indiscipline is so serious, we have to take action against this. Now, we cannot dismiss the person directly like that. That is why it is necessary that you have to go through the proper procedure. Whenever there is a misconduct, for example, he has worked below the norms, plus he has abused the supervisor, neglected the order, and he has instigated others to stop the work. For example, whenever if I want to take an action against this particular person, what is the procedure? The first one, I get a written report. Suppose he is supervisor in that particular department and this particular person is having a misconduct. What you being a supervisor, you are going to give a written report to HR, to me. So this is this, this happened and this is wrong on his part. You and this has happened at this time in this shift. You are going to give me a written report. After I get a written report, I am going to understand that investigations we will make from our end. Investigation takes place from our end. What exactly has happened, when it has happened, who is responsible, what that worker was doing, what supervisor was doing. After investigating, we are understanding the pros and cons. Pros and cons, if I take an action, this will happen. If I don't take action, this will happen. Because if there is some kind of misconduct, we cannot overlook or we cannot just leave like that. There will be a boomerang on us. So if I take the action, this will happen. If I don't take this action, this will happen. Suppose, if I get to know that a misconduct is not that severe, is not that way, bad that way, or it's not that severe, you can say, we just give the warning. My friend, it is being noticed against you that you have done this. Hereby we warn you to keep away from such a wrongdoing, otherwise serious action will be taken in future. Warning, leave it. But if the misconduct is so severe, what are you going to do? We are going to frame the charge sheet. Framing charge sheet. It's a very typical language. We frame the charge sheet. See, charge sheet. Mr. Prakash Rao, ticket number so and so, department store, subject charge sheet. Never to write down, dear, darling, no. Mr. Prakash, it is being reported against you that you were scheduled in the first shift in store department, unit number 5, at exactly 9 o'clock when your supervisor told you to start the work, but in return, you have neglected his order. On the contrary, you have abused him. And plus you have instigated others to stop the work. The above mentioned act is a misact according to Model Standing Order Act. You have to give the explanation on above within 48 hours. Otherwise, it will be constant of the management to take legal action against you. How see the wording is? Charge sheet. We are going to issue that charge sheet. Issuing charge sheet. Once you issue the charge sheet, that particular person will have to give the explanation within 48 hours. Now, whatever explanation he gives, if you are happy, it's okay. But the management is not happy, they're going to write. Whatever explanation you are given, management is not agreed to that, and we have decided to conduct inquiry against you. In that case, you have to have appointment of inquiry officer. Appointment of inquiry officer. Who is going to inquire? He can be a third person from outside. Now, after being appointed by inquiry officer, we'll fix the date of inquiry. At the same level, we will send a letter to that worker that we have appointed inquiry officer and your inquiry is being conducted on Friday at 9 o'clock in conference room, whatever it is. There, that inquiry process starts. Inquiry process starts. In that inquiry, this particular person, management inquiry officer, this is a worker, this is management representative. In front of these, that process will start. Both parties will get a chance to prove in what they are not wrong. Every party will try to prove that they are not guilty or he is not guilty. Whatever the cross-examination takes place, maine aisa bola, apne aisa bola, apne aisa bola, apne aisa bola, the way it goes on. And that inquiry officer is not supposed to ask any question. He notes down that. What you said, what I said, what you said, what I said, what the way your documentary you are given as a proof, exhibiting the proof, whatever you exhibited, he will note down. Right from the first sitting, he writes down all the cross-examination which has taken place between these two people. And after that, some time, this inquiry officer will tell you, will ask both the party, do you want to say anything more? He says, no. Do you want to say anything more? No. Then on the basis of that inquiry, which being made, cross-examination, like the cross-examination being done, on the basis of that, he writes down a inquiry report. He prepares inquiry report. What is the inquiry report? Like, I have gone through the cross-examination between these two parties and I have come to the conclusion to say this particular person is guilty and liable for punishment. This report, that particular inquiry officer will have to give to top management. He is not supposed to tell which kind of punishment it is. He writes down that this particular person is guilty and liable for punishment. Then the management will decide about the punishment. Punishment is being given by the management. Now, what the punishment can be? Again, sometime it goes this way, leave it, or sometime dismiss the person, sometime suspend the person, discharge. This kind of activities, punishment takes place. Again, I am telling you, warning, punishment, suspension or dismissal. Dismissal is a permanent separation. Suspension is not a permanent separation. Warning, just a warning, not to repeat that way. That is also not a separation. Now, are you clear with what a procedure for domestic inquiry? Clear? This is the punishment we call it as. See, what kind of punishments are? The form of punishments are see here. It can be warning. It can be suspension. It can be suspension pending inquiry. It can be dismissal or a discharge. See, when it comes to the level that punishment, that particular misconduct is not severe, management will think of it again, and if it is not that, will just give the warning that this thing should not repeat again. That's it. Next one, suspension. Like sometimes it happens when a person is found guilty, but punishment, that grievance is not that severe, we do suspend the person. After conducting inquiry, I may write a